Hello, hello, hello. Welcome, welcome, welcome. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, wherever you may be. Welcome back to my channel, my lovelies. If you've never been here before, thank you so much for clicking on my video. I am so happy you found me. I do so hope that you will like and subscribe before you leave. Become part of the mom family. Mama's got your back, at least where makeup's concerned. And definitely when that makeup is cheap. Today, it is once again that time of the month. It is time for BoxyCharm. I am so super excited. This is going to be the BoxyCharm base box unboxing for the month of December 2022. It is the last box of the month. It is also the Christmas box. So I'm really, really hopeful that there is a lot of really fun, special makeup in here. I cannot wait to go through this with you guys. In all honesty, I have tried to film this video once before and I was interrupted, so we're restarting. So I have kind of pretty much seen everything that's in here, so it's not going to be like a let's experience it together kind of thing, but it is a pretty good box, so I am super excited to share it with you guys. Without too much babbling, let's go ahead and dive right into it. So if you don't know much about BoxyCharm, BoxyCharm is basically a makeup subscription box. You get sent five full-sized products every single month. Usually you have the choice to pick one of your products. It's usually a mixture of skincare, makeup, and makeup tools. Lately, it's been a whole lot of skincare and not very much makeup, but hopefully this box is going to be just a little bit different. Now, hopefully we're going to have a lot of good makeup in here. This is the Christmas box, and I know for a lot of us, this is basically the only present that we're going to get this month. A lot of us spend all month trying to scramble around and make sure everybody else has an amazing Christmas, and then, you know, we're left Christmas morning with not much to unopen under the tree, not much to open under the tree. So boxes like this become super, super important. So I really hope that they didn't let us down this month. We're just going to go ahead and dive right in. So the first thing that we have to pull out of the box is the little pamphlet. It says, "Tis the season for being extra." So hopefully that means there's going to be some super extra amazing makeup in here this month. I don't know. We shall see. The first product on here is, oh, my choice, which is the Dominique Cosmetics Unconditional Palette. Where did it go? Oh, I put it back in the box. Okay, so Dominique, Kristen Dominique is a YouTuber. She is like an OG YouTuber. She is very sweet, very cute, but she is a plain Jane, basic makeup kind of girl. She enjoys browns and mauves, and with this palette, that's basically what you're getting. So it says, colors you'll adore from the moments you'll cherish, for the moments you'll cherish. This palette includes six warm, buttery shades ranging from rosy hues to rich burgundy. With a mix of shimmers, mattes, and even a glitter finish, you can create endless looks for all the gatherings and fun events ahead. Ultra pigmented, super blendable, and perfect for those days and nights. MSRP is for $28. So, first of all, this feels really nice and heavy. Kristen usually has really great packaging. I have noticed that a lot of the YouTuber or influencer brands usually do have pretty great packaging, which I am super, super thankful for. $28 is not crazy expensive, especially not for a quality palette. But it is still more than I'm willing to pay for a six pan from any brand, basically. But the packaging is so, so beautiful. So this is what the actual palette looks like. It is stunning, super, super heavy. It feels luxurious. It feels expensive. The experience of the palette is beautiful already. You open it up and you get a nice full-size mirror. On the mirror is an inscription. It says, love the moment, you'll cherish the memories. And Kristen is a very, what is the word? Sentimental. She is a very sentimental person, which I think is just absolutely the sweetest. And then here is your color story. Looks like you have three mattes, two shimmers, and a pressed glitter. I know if you are not into pressed glitter, that's probably going to be a big bummer for you. I actually enjoy a good pressed glitter, so I'm not super, you know, about it, but it does just look to me like it's a standard pressed glitter formula. It does look like it's got a little bit of that Vaseline-y kind of texture in there to really keep everything stuck together. So that lets me know that it's probably going to go on the eye pretty easily without having to use a glitter glue or anything like that, which is nice. The three mattes in here are, you got a deeper tone, a mid tone, and then a lighter matte. So it makes a complete thought. It's going to be very, very easy to make a beautiful eye look with this palette. So on top of the three mattes, you have two shimmers. I have swatched the mattes already, and I don't think that they feel particularly special in any way, but the shimmers do feel nice. They feel buttery and a little bit creamy. So there is the darkest matte swatched and the darkest shimmer swatched. Again, it is a pretty palette. We'll have to use it for the next Makeup Monday. Yeah, nothing super, super special. The packaging is beautiful. I definitely will get use out of this though. These are my go-to comfort colors. I love a good rosy mauve kind of eye, and this is just straight up my alley. I think the addition of a pressed glitter is super fun. Brings a little bit of glam and pop to the palette. So very, very pretty. Not something I would have picked up for myself, but a very pretty palette nevertheless. The next thing we have is a more eye cream. Y'all, what is it about BoxyCharm and eye cream? It seems like we're getting a different eye cream every single month. They're sending them to me faster than I can get through them. I am still working on my Alginist Triple Algae Eye Renewal Balm. But I guess it's good that we got a new one because I'm almost out of it. But this is my favorite eye balm or eye cream that they've sent us so far, and I'm almost out of it. So I guess it's good that we got a new one. Also, it's from the brand Murad, which is a super expensive brand and really nice quality skincare. So let's read what they have to say about it. It says, prevent and reduce the look of wrinkles all around the eyes, including the lids, with patented retinol tri-active technology for potent yet gentle results. All ages and sensitive skin welcome. Helps minimize the signs of aging you can see and the ones you can't see yet. Provides 24 hours of hydration to reduce dryness as it instantly brightens. Delivers an instant dose of retinol and a dose of retinol over time to minimize irritation and prolong the benefits. Says that MSRP is for $89 freaking dollars. $89 is a whole lot of money to spend on an eye cream, and definitely something I could never do. This is one of those brands that I probably couldn't even buy this if it was on sale. So I am excited to get this in the box. It is a really, really nice brand. What does it say on the box? It says, restorative retinol serum for under eyes and lids help improve the look of lines, wrinkles, and loss of firmness. Rapidly smooths while being gentle enough for the eye area. Features Murad's retinol tri-active technology, a fast-acting retinoid, and a time-release retinol. That's a retinol booster. Anyway, really, really nice. And you know, you always got to give it up for Murad packaging. This is what the actual product looks like. Very, very pretty. Murad packaging is like, to me, a mixture of minimalistic, modern, and sciencey, kind of. It just kind of looks clinical. The packaging looks very, very clinical. It looks like it's almost been prescribed to you by a doctor. And I think that is, it's a nice feeling, right? Makes you feel like it's going to work. Makes you feel like it's going to be effective. So that's always nice. With products, it's just as much about the way they make you feel as the way that they perform. And, you know, I'm excited to kind of test this one out. Again, I've never tried it, so I can't give you guys any real advice on it. But I am excited to try it. I'm excited to test it out. And I got wrinkles for days. I got crow's feet for days. So hopefully it'll help me out with that just a little bit. The next product on the list is, So LaRousse Beauty, we got a LaRousse Beauty three-piece brush set. Now, I don't get brushes very often from BoxyCharm, but whenever I do, I'm usually pleasantly surprised. What does it say about this one? It says, apply, blend, and smudge your favorite cream and powder eyeshadow formulas and slay your favorite looks with these essential brushes. MSRP is for $38. $38 for three brushes. Y'all, these brushes better look like absolute, just like they better be made of gold. Okay, so let's open it up. First of all, it comes in this really cute burgundy paper envelope. Very, very cute. I like that it's paper and not plastic, less waste. It's biodegradable. That is always nice. I also really enjoy this color combination of the burgundy and the gold together. I think it's very, very pretty. You open it up and Oh, how pretty. Okay, so these are super, super pretty. First of all, right off the bat, I am impressed with the shapes of the brushes. A lot of times when you get a brush set, it's usually like an eyebrow brush, a flat shader brush, and then like a flat packing brush. I love the fact that you get a big fat fluffy blender, you get a fluffy eyeshadow brush, and then you also get a small detail blender. I think that is a fantastic, fantastic selection of shapes, especially in, like a Christmas or if you do your makeup, 9 times out of 10, these are the three brushes that you're gonna reach for. I know that I use all three of these shapes every single time I do my makeup, so I'm exceptionally happy with the selection of shapes that we got. Moving on from that, I think that the actual brushes themselves are beautiful. I love that they have this bright, almost rosy toned gold ferrule, and then you have this deep, dark wine burgundy kind of handle. I think, again, the color combination is stunning. Talking about the actual bristles themselves, they feel very, very soft. They almost feel like they're natural hair brushes. I'm not sure if these are natural hair or synthetic. It's, what does it say? Designed in California, made in China. I don't know if it says cruelty free. I'm not sure. I don't see a leaping bunny on the packaging anywhere. So I'm gonna go ahead and assume that these are natural bristles. I could very well be wrong and these could be synthetic. And if that's the case, I do apologize. They just feel very, very soft. A lot softer than I'm used to my synthetic bristles being. Other than that, I think that they're beautiful. They feel beautiful in the hand. The actual grips are texturized. I don't know if you can see that, but they have this kind of waffling pattern on the grips that gives in a soft matte, almost rubberized texture that just gives them a really beautiful feel in the hand. They also have a nice weight to them as well. Not too heavy, but not super light as to feel cheap. These are really nice quality brushes. I am very, very excited about this. These could quite possibly be my favorite thing that I've unboxed in this month's BoxyCharm so far. I think that these are beautiful. I do wish that it was a set of 5 instead of 3, but I'm not going to gripe too awful much. I am very pleasantly surprised with the selection of these brush shapes. And I'm very much looking forward to using these on my eyes. I think that is a gorgeous, gorgeous brush set. Do I think it's worth $38? No. That makes it almost, what, $12, $11 a brush? No. Not when I can get my Do Color set for $13 for 15 brushes. No, thank you. No, thank you. But very nice. It's a nice thought. The next thing we have is the Real Her Blurring Veil Set Your Goal Powder. So this is what it looks like. What does it have to say about this one? It says features ultra finely milled powders, which melt into the skin to set your makeup in place or to control excess oils. It's completely flashback and talc-free to give any look some serious staying power. MSRP is for $25. So it's $25. You get 8 grams, 0.28 ounces. So not a ton of product in here. $25. I've never used or tried anything from the brand Real Her before. I do think that the packaging looks really nice. Again, you've got that rose gold and black kind of color combination. It's just striking. It's very, very pretty, very aesthetic. The packaging looks high quality. I'm not sure what the actual powder is going to be like, but we shall see. I do think $25 for this tiny thing of powder is a little bit expensive. I do know that you can get the Laura Mercier powder for like $30, and it is a much, much bigger tub of powder. So I think that's a bit much. But the actual packaging is, again, just the same color combination as on the outward packaging. Again, you have black and rose gold, very, very pretty. You open it up. And this is, you just have it looks like drugstore packaging, very much drugstore packaging. There's no special sifter, there's no net or screen. It's basically just a plastic sifter in there. Let's go ahead and touch the powder. The powder, I will say, does feel beautifully finely milled. It feels super, super silky and smooth on the fingers, which lets me know that it's probably going to be pretty smoothing on the skin as well. I'm a little bit worried about the pigmentation in there. It looks awfully peachy, which will work for my skin, but maybe not for everybody. And I don't know how pigmented the powder is, so I don't know if that's gonna like show up when you use it to set your face. Let's see if we can do a little bit of a swatch. Let's see if it adds any coverage. So you can see it just a little bit on the back of my hand. So it's not a true translucent powder. Yeah, there is a little bit of color and a little bit of coverage there. I think what's going to happen is this is going to translate into a little bit of a brightening powder, which is always a good thing. And again, we will make sure and use this for next week's new Makeup Monday. But yeah, I'm not super excited about it. Yeah, it's not my favorite product. Powder is one of those things that's so incredibly personal. You know, if you have dry skin, if you have oily skin, not all powders are created equal. And again, powder is just not one of those exciting products. Powder is not an exciting product for me. Give me eyeliner. Give me a funky eyeshadow palette. Give me contour. Give me blush. But powder, you know, and especially not in a box that's, you know, I'm supposed to be exploring luxury makeup with, I can get basically the same thing. Like, do I think in any way, shape, or form that this is going to outperform my L'Oreal True Match powder? No, ma'am. No, ma'am. I do not. And this I can get for much cheaper than this at the drugstore. You know what I mean? Just send me some Laura Mercier. Send me some Laura Mercier and maybe I would be impressed. But with this, not so much. We'll have to see how it performs. I don't want to knock it too hard, but just not a very exciting product. And then we were down to one. We're on the last product. And the last product in our box this month is La Palette Beauty Vita Yellow Fresh Cleanser. It's a cleanser. It's a cleanser. Y'all, it's a very cute bottle of cleanser, but it is cleanser nonetheless. So what does it have to say about this box of cleanser? Let's see. This one-step vitamin C cleanser helps to brighten your skin while removing debris and makeup. A jelly cleanser, it contains 88% moisturizing essence to keep your skin hydrated. MSRP is for $32. Now, I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to stop you right there, and I'm going to tell you that No. Do you know how many of these jelly cleansers I've gotten in boxes over however many period of time, however long period of time? And they're all terrible. I do not think that jelly cleansers work. That is, of course, my personal opinion. But I don't think that jelly cleansers work. I don't think that they are very effective at taking your makeup off, especially not as a first step. I think that you have to go in with either a cleansing balm or a makeup melter of some form to really get the makeup off. And then this would maybe be a second step cleanser. What does it say? A skin barrier patented ingredient. It's got aqua ceramide in it. This one-step cleanser helps to make your skin shine and glow by delivering vitality and energy to the to tired skin with a word that I cannot produce, extract, and pure vitamin C. This is not a sexy product. This is not like, okay, so that's what it looks like. I will say the packaging is very, very cute. Would I ever pay $32 for this bottle of cleanser? I most certainly would not. Let's go ahead and open it and smell it. I don't think it smells too awful much like anything. There might be, is it sealed? Yeah, it's sealed. That's why I can't smell anything. Okay, definitely smells like lemon. It smells like lemon. It has a very citrusy kind of scent to it. It has a very thick, very sticky, jelly-like consistency. Y'all, this feels exactly like the e.l.f. jelly cleanser. And that thing, I love e.l.f. so, so very much, but that jelly cleanser is absolutely abysmal. I don't feel like this. Let's try. Let's see. I'm gonna take a little bit on my neck right here and rub it in and see if it actually removes any of my makeup or if it just kind of absorbs into my skin and dries up like all the other ones do. I have my makeup eraser right here. Nothing. It doesn't remove makeup. It doesn't remove makeup. It is not a first step product at all whatsoever. This is a second step cleanser at best. And as a second step cleanser, I just don't feel like a jelly cleanser gets your skin clean enough to really do anything. I will test this out and I'll use it with water and see if it foams up or lathers or does anything special. But this is disappointing. This is definitely not a product that they should have given us in our December BoxyCharm. I think for the most part, this box is equal parts upsetting and exciting. I think that this is definitely my least favorite product of the bunch. I think that this is basically just like a cop-out. And the reason that they have these in the BoxyCharms is because nobody buys them because they don't work. People don't buy them. They end up with an excess amount of product and they just have to figure out how to get rid of it, basically. And they shoved it in our BoxyCharms and just making us deal with it now. This is upsetting. This is upsetting. I don't like this. That's basically a wear. It smells nice, but again, we don't want this. So definitely my least favorite product of the bunch. I'm again gonna say that my favorite product out of the entire bunch were the La Rousse Beauty brushes and the Murad eye cream. Again, but even with the eye cream, we get sent an eye cream every other month. It's either every other or every single month. So again, nothing exciting, nothing new. It's disappointing. It's disappointing. You know, you think that BoxyCharm, I don't even know what to say at this point. I just hope that there are not too many of you guys out there that are upset by this month's BoxyCharm. My heart breaks for you if it makes you sad. And you know, the thing that makes me mad is not every woman has the amount of makeup that I do. You know, I can kind of brush it off, right? Because I do have my makeup to play with. But there are so many women out there that order BoxyCharms every month, really, really hoping to get something special and to be excited. And you know, maybe to other women, maybe this is exciting and maybe I'm just a little bit jaded. Let me know in the comments below if you feel the same way I do, or if, you know, maybe I'm being a little bit harsh. I do think that I try to be as fair as I can be. But again, with all of the eye cream and the jelly cleansers and things like that, I just think that it's products that we definitely are not hoping. Like, we're not hoping, oh, I hope I get a jelly cleanser in my box this month. You know what I mean? Especially not when we can go to the drugstore and pick up the e.l.f. one that does exactly the same thing, which is nothing, for a fraction of the price. Guys, that's going to be it for me and for this month's BoxyCharm unboxing. I hope that you enjoyed the video. As always, I will have everything in this video in the description box below, along with all the other tags to my social medias, Facebook, Instagram, all that good stuff. I do have this look, this absolutely stunning look. I love it so, so very much. I did make a TikTok on this look. It will be coming very, very shortly. As always, no filters, no edits, no fancy lighting. Yeah, no fancy lighting. It's just me sitting in front of my camera, unboxing my BoxyCharm, hoping you guys are enjoying what I'm doing. And until next time, stay safe, take care of yourselves, and remember, you're important. Bye.